So, if you're new here and you like tech content, click that subscribe button below and turn on notifications for future content. Let's go with this video. So in front of me, I have two devices. Both are not the iPhone 12 or the iPhone SE because both devices are not yet available. But this is the iPhone XR and the iPhone 7, which both devices look a bit like the iPhone 12 on the right side and the iPhone SE on the left side. Now let's compare these two devices. So the SE has been unveiled, is officially released and is available for pre-order, while the iPhone 12 is still leaked. A lot of leaks have been released on the iPhone 12 by Ben Jeskin, for example, Everything Apple Pro, John Prosser or Max Weinbach. All these are available to find on Twitter or on YouTube with all the links below, of course, as well. Now, based on these leaks, I made a comparison between the iPhone SE, the new iPhone SE. This is, of course, not a new iPhone SE. And the iPhone 12. This is also not an iPhone 12, but I made the comparison. Let's check out which one you should buy for the price. Now, this so-called iPhone SE comes in an iPhone 8 body. This is an iPhone 7, but very similar to the iPhone 8, of course, with an iPhone 8 body, with a glass back, with wireless charging and all that stuff. So we already know how this is going to look, with, of course, the home button and the fingerprint sensor on the front. There's one size, and that's the 4.7 inch size, which is not a very big size. This is this size, so compared to the iPhone XR, that's a lot smaller, as you can see. Now the iPhone 12 will be really focused on the iPad Pro design and the iPhone 5 design. Yeah, the iPhone 5 design. Why? Well, because the angles will be sharper and flatter. So this one is actually very curved, as you can see, and that's the effect with the iPhone 11 as well, for example, but these will be flatter and a bit sharper as well. So based on the CAD design, which I couldn't get my hands on, unfortunately, because I don't have a big channel, but Everything Apple Pro made a video on that, it looks like they will be nice to hold in hand. Of course, the difference between these two is you have a home button over here and very big bezels, while you have the notch over here on the iPhone 12. This is an iPhone XR. So the notch will be smaller, they say, on the iPhone 12. So that's already a very big difference, and that's something they are not really sure about today, of course. There are even reports that the iPhone 12 won't have a notch and that everything will be featured in the top bezel, which would be weird, so I'm thinking they will stick to the notch, maybe a bit smaller, but not that much. Now for the screens, the iPhone SE will have an LCD Retina HD display, so that's a very basic display, similar to the iPhone XR, but the iPhone 12 will have an OLED screen. All the different sizes of the iPhone 12 will have an OLED screen, and sizes will go from 5.4 inch to 6.1 inch or even bigger on the Pro models, but we're talking about the iPhone 12, of course, right now. So I imagine the screen on the iPhone 12 to be very, very good. Now, it has been said a lot, the iPhone SE will have the A13 Bionic chip processor. That's the same on the iPhone 11, which is a very major step up for a budget phone of that price to have an A13 Bionic chip. The iPhone 12 will, of course, have the A14 Bionic chip, which will be even better. But I'm always asking the question, why do you need an A14 Bionic chip, for example, to play mobile games? Because even my iPhone SE, which doesn't have the A13, which still has the A12 Bionic chip, by the way, can't play games smoothly. So I don't know, maybe they'll come up with crazy games in the next couple of years while you'll need an A14 Bionic chip. But for now, I don't really see the reason why you would need such a very grand chip to play games. Another thing that might be available on the iPhone 12 is the 120Hz refresh rate, which would make sure that your screen is extremely fluid as never before. On the back of the device, there will be three cameras on the iPhone 12. So this is the iPhone XR, it only has one, but there will be three cameras with an advanced LiDAR scanner as well. While on the iPhone SE, this will be this camera. It will actually be this camera of the iPhone XR converted to the new iPhone SE. So it will be the same camera on the iPhone SE as we have on the iPhone XR right now. So as for camera goes, big win for the iPhone 12, but of course the price difference is there as well. But three cameras, it will be the best camera setup on an iPhone so far. The battery, which I always find important on these devices, on the iPhone SE, is the same battery as on the iPhone 8, which means 1821 milliamp hours, which gives you 13 hours of battery life on daily usage, which is a full day, which is about A bit less than the iPhone XR, but very similar after a while. On the iPhone 12, however, they will make the battery 50% smaller and thinner, but still the battery capacity will be better than on the iPhone 11. On the iPhone 11, you have a 3110 mAh battery, which gives you 17 hours of battery life. So I'm assuming that it will be around 20 hours of battery life on the iPhone 12, which is amazing. More than a day of battery life on an iPhone. Who would have thought that? Now, and then last thing, the price. Of course, we already know the iPhone SE will retail for $399. That is a bargain for what you're getting. Really, this is, for that price, poof, very crazy. I'm like, Apple really wants to get rid of all these extra parts of other devices they have left, probably, so they are selling them for $399, while the iPhone 12 will probably, in my guess, cost about $1,199 or $1,099, more or less, because it will have the 5G, of course. If we compare the price between the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 11, the iPhone 12 retailed for $999 on release. Why now? I think the iPhone 12 will retail for a bit more, about $1,099 or $1,199 with the 5G, of course, the triple camera and all the new internals that are featured in the iPhone. So yeah, conclusion, if you want a phone for less than half of the price of the iPhone 12, get the iPhone SE. It's a very good phone for $399, but still the iPhone 12 will be the next big thing. It will be a very major upgrade from the iPhone 12 and all the other iPhone models we have seen the last couple of years. So it will be really nice to see that in tech land, tech community, for all the tech people will be like screaming when the iPhone 12 comes out. If it comes out this year, we will never know because of the corona crisis, of course, but we'll see. Normally it should release about in September, November, somewhere like that. But there are reports that it might be delayed, but we'll see that in a couple of months, of course. Now, I don't know if you can wait for the iPhone 12 if you're considering buying an iPhone SE, but if you're considering right now buying an iPhone SE, I would just go for it. It's $399 and this will sell like crazy, probably. So just buy the iPhone SE, you'll be very happy with it. And for $399, you really can't go wrong. If you still want to buy an iPhone 12, then maybe, I don't know, next year the $399 will already be forgotten and then you can buy the iPhone 12. Alright, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed, feel free to click that subscribe button below if you're not yet subscribed, and click that like button as well. And I hope I'll see you in my next video.